Hello children, welcome to our English classroom today. Well, you all know that this is the month where children enjoy very much. I hope you all know that the importance of this month. What do children do during this month? Most of you might go to picnic, right? So when you go to picnic, usually what you do? Obviously, you enjoy a lot and you play games, right? And even one more thing, there is one special and moment happened this month, if you recollect once, in the field of cricket. And it's none other than the retirement of the little master Sachin Tendulkar. Now, similarly, in our today's lesson,
to do?
Run.
I told him, how do you ever participate in a running race?
Oh, you may have participated. Good.
And I asked you one thing, what does the physical education teacher say to begin the running race? Can anybody say? Usually, the PT says, on your mark, get, set, go, right? And even there will be some sports persons in your school, and when there will be a lot of competitions in your school, maybe August 15th or Republic Day, or even recently the 7th day, right? So now, who is the fastest runner in your school? And after that, I just think, and the winner gets something. What does the winner get? In our school, they give prizes. And if you go to sports, I mean district level or national level, you'll get awards. Now look at this sports person, PT Usha, he has full of medals. So that's why we call her the golden girl, right? Now children, you want to know more about PT Usha? Then open your books and read the first two paragraphs individually and underline the new words using a pencil. Open your books, just read the first two paragraphs. Okay children, I hope you are doing that. Now children, after this, you can get into groups and share the new words that you have underlined with the other members of the group. And again, if you don't understand anything, you can ask your friends also in the group, right? Just think which sentence would you like most. And if you don't understand any sentence also, just try to underline and put a question mark. Then we will come to you. That's it. Now let us look at the glossary. What you can find in this two paragraphs. The first one is instinctive, arising from natural ability, right? And arena, a place where public events of concerts take place. You can say a spectacular sports arena. And then you can find the other word like extraordinary. A person or a team has extremely good or special quality. You can say it's an extraordinary person. Right? And the another one is to find about that other word, that is vigorously working with strength and energy, how people are work and practice the game. And the last one maybe seems to be tiny and it is so small. But children, now let us look at the passage. So listen carefully while I read. PT Usha, India. This was the address on a letter from the Middle East. The letter was delivered by the Postal Department with no delay whatsoever. Right, this is the setting of the scene. Now, and this was the status of Pillavulla Kandi Chakkuparambil Usha, who was born as the second daughter of Paithal and Lakshmi Amma on 20th May 1964 in the village of Payoli, Kozhikode district, Kerala. Right, maybe it is somewhat, what I mean to say is, it's somewhat difficult for us to understand that word as we are not familiar with those words like Pillavulla Kandi, Chakkuparambil Usha. And you can see that Payoli, Kozhikode district, which are the famous district in Kerala. And now let us look at the first thing, question for you. Tell the full name of PT Usha. Just try to remember. If not, you just look at your book. And now the next question is, when was P.T. Usha born? Now children, look at here. The full name of P.T. Usha is Pilavulla Tandi Petta Parambil Usha. And when was P.T. Usha born means, P.T. Usha was born on 20th May 1964. This is the primary information of P.T. Usha. And now let us go in detail. It was November 1973 when a dedicated physical education teacher called Balakrishnan discovered Usha. While conversing with the parent, his eyes that were watchful kept drifting to a group of small birds playing blind man's bluff just across the field. Right, children? You might have observed two persons here in this paragraph. So one is the physical education teacher, Balakrishnan, and another one is a girl who was playing a game. And this name is not familiar to you, but the game, I hope that everybody is familiar. The blind man's bluff is managed just like a blindfold game. Okay? While playing this blind man's bluff, the PUT observed very carefully about the and just think what happens next. And after the observation of PUT, what he has done. Now let us go into detail. Right. So the first person who discovered the sports talent in Usha and when? Just recollect the things in the passage and then try to say who discovered the sports talent in Usha and when. And at the same time, what qualities of the physical education teacher are mentioned in the passage. These are the two things you might have observed while you read and you heard the passage. Right? Could have discovered the sports talent in Usha? And it's none other than the physical education teacher, Balakrishnan. And when did he discover? While she was playing the blindfold game, right? Next children, every person has certain qualities. Okay? There are two particular qualities mentioned in the passage about the physical education teacher. That is, he was watchful and dedicated, right? And now let us see. So after his observation, what he found was, now let us read the passage once again. Was there a pair of feet that were moving extraordinarily fast? Was the tiny dark girl in a blue skirt and white blouse moving like an instinctive athlete? Patient as ever, Balakrishnan waited for the game to be over. Now, what the PD has observed here is, he has observed how her feet were moving the way it was extraordinary. And what he found is even the instinctive ability of the athlete. You know, it was a natural ability. Up to that time, she was not a runner. Just she was playing the game. But as an observant and watchful beauty, she observed that she has got that ability. So she waited patiently until the game was over. Then can you think what might have happened? So obviously, she will go to the girl. Now, could you think there's a little girl in the story? It's none other than. Yeah? Come on, think about it. It is P.T. Usha. And describe the little girl. You might have heard some words when I read. Just think about it. And how the world has been moving. Shall we look at it? Who is that little girl now? And that little girl is none other than Pithivita. And if you want to describe that little girl, you found some words like tiny, dark, or something. And how about her feet moving? And her feet were moving extraordinarily, right? Now let us look at it. The little girl was Pithivita. And she was a tiny, dark girl with a blue skirt and white blouse. There was no sports uniform by that time. As soon as when we came, and regarding her feet, I told you that her feet were moving extraordinarily fast. This is what the PET has got to. Now let us see. So as soon as she has seen the girl, she then started like this. Calling the little girl, she gently inquired of her, "What's your name, child?" The shy little girl hardly raised her eyes from the ground. She whispered and added, "Contractful." When the PET has seen and observed her ability, she went near the girl and she inquired of her, right? What was her name? And she was a little girl, and obviously she was feeling shy. And she told slowly, like this one. And even she told the class also. That was fourth class, right? And now let us see. What's your name, child? Who is the speaker of this verse? So it is just this. Who has seen the girl's ability and who has inquired? And now, when her sports talent was recognized, what was her age? And who recognized it? Well, let us see now. Just think, and then let's go now. So, what's your name, child? Who is the speaker of these words? Are spoken by the physical education teacher, Balakrishnan. And at what age was Uta's sports talent recognized first? Obviously, you know, when she was 4 years old. And who did it miss? It's none other than Balakrishnan. Right? Now, children. That was made one of the greatest discoveries in the athletic arena of Asia. A simple question from an observant master and an equally unassuming answer from a tiny village girl from a distant village in Malba, in Kerala. So this is what the greatest discovery. Okay? He found one jewel, right? And that was none other than Pithivita. How he could find was, he was quite observant. And then came the answer. And as he was, it was a distant village right in Malwa, in Kerala. Generally, village children will have great potential. The same way what the master PET has observed is her instinctive ability. Now let us see what will happen. So that same evening at 4:15 p.m., Usha heard the magical words for the first time in her life. "On your mark, get set, go." The master had explained to her what to do and why, confused, but very much aware of the seriousness of the occasion, she ran for her life. The rest is history. Right, children? You might have heard the history, how she has created. So, for the first time, when she heard that magical voice, like on your mark, get, set, go. That was the beginning. And even the master told and explained everything what to do and what not to do. Initially, it was a bit confused, but later on, the seriousness, you know, she was very sincere, and whatever master told, she followed. And even I told you, that practice is not ordinary. It was a rigorous practice, and with that practice, and she created the history. Now, just remember, let us look at the question. What were the magical words that Usha heard for the first time in her life? What qualities in Usha made her great in athletics? Well, what were the magical words? Yeah, I told you that the PET tells in the beginning of a running race. It's another thing. On your mark, get, set, go. Right? And what are the qualities in Usha made her great in athletics? Right? And she has the sincerity, I mean, so called, she was very serious in her business, like running. And at the same time, she has done vigorous practice, very hard, using all her strength. She did it, and that was the history she has made. Now, so this is what we are seeing. You can make it out. What were the magical words that Usha heard for the first time in her life? On your mark, get, set, go. And the second one is, what are the qualities in Usha has made the great in athletics? It was seriousness and rigorous practice. Now, children, here are two questions for you. Just think about it and try to write the answers, whatever comes to your mind, and then you can share with us. What ideas came to Balakrishna when he saw Usha moving her feet extraordinarily? And how does Usha's life inspire the young girls of our country? She's the inspirer, right? So, you just think here, we are talking about two important persons. One is the PET master who has observed her potentiality and the qualities. And the second one is the inspirer we are talking about is Usha, and how she has created the history and how she inspired several girls in our country. Now, it's left for you. Well, let us look at the vocabulary here. Now, we have learned about the sports and games, and here is one task for you. Classify the following words into sports and games, and add other games or sports you know to the list. What are the games you can find here? Volleyball, cricket, running, chess, badminton, table tennis, soccer, swimming, basketball, lawn tennis, long jump. Even you can add some other sports like high jump. But we didn't find the hop, step and jump. There are discus throw and short put. You might have known several events. So just try to recollect and write it on your notebook. Afterwards, you put the table, divide it. Then you can keep it sports and games, the two columns. In the sports column, there is one event already we have written, like running. And then you go for the games of cricket, and you try to classify all the words and complete the table. And here is one more task for you. And look at the table. There are very familiar and famous players. We have given the list. And in the past is you first of all identify all the sports persons, and then what you have to do is everybody is familiar and supposed to one popular game, and you have to find out what game they are famous for. The first one is done for you, that is chess. You know that is Vishwanathan Anand and Hockey, who has won Alfredo, the India captain, who Alfredo has to bring a gold medal in the field of the hockey. It's Nanu Jansen and cricket, a sensational and the cricket legend. But now that everybody can say that is Sachin Tendulkar and the upcoming sports person in the field of badminton is Saina Nehwal, and in the shooting it is Gajan Mehta, right? So now let us look about writing an application. Just children, just once recollect before, I hope you are all studying 6th class, and soon after completing the 5th class, when you wanted to join in this school, you might have done something. Just try to remember children. The first one is, how are you admitted into your school? After primary school, now you are in 6th class, and how are you admitted? Number two, what should be seen in while joining into a school? Sometimes, I know that most of the teachers fill your applications and they bring to the school as seen. Sometimes your parents fill and bring, or sometimes you ask your friends to fill the application. So now, let us know how to fill an application, and generally, let us look at what does an application consist. Can you remember? If you look at your admission application form, you'll find name of the candidate, then you'll find name of the father, and can you remember the school where you study, and the class you pass, and they will ask about the conduct also, and finally they will ask student signature and parent signature also. This is what the content of the application generally. Now let us look at the P.T. Usha's application when she wanted to admit in a sports school. We know children, there are sports schools also, like that P.T. Usha wants to join a sports school. Before that, she has to fill one form. Let us see what is there in that. And here, I read it for you. So name, you have to write her name. And father's name, looking at your middle, I told you, I tell Amma something. And that you have to write there. Date of birth, you have to write according to our passage. And the age, you have to write. And then, what you have to write is whether male or female. And the next one is name of the school where she studied and the class to be admitted, signature of the candidate. These are the important things which consist of an application. Now, children, after writing this application, looking at your reader, now I'm going to give you one more task. It's about for you. Think that you want to change your school after 7th class. Right? And if you want to study in 8th class, how you will fill this application. This is a task for you. Please fill the application by completing all the details. Right, children? You can write your name, you can write the father's name, your date of birth, age, male or female, name of the school where you study. Now, here, there's a small mistake, right? You can say where you study, right? And then class to be admitted, and finally you can show signature of the candidate. Okay, children? Here I am going to give you one more task. Just listen to this. Did you enjoy? So you might have witnessed all your father's cricketers there. And now, children, I told you that this is a month which will be memorable for all the sports and game flowers. And that is the retirement of the great Sachin Tendulkar. Right? So now I want to give you some information related to the living master. Go through all the information and try to write a small paragraph about your father's cricketer, Sachin Tendulkar. Now, look at this. So, this is the person who has created sensation in the field of cricket. So, who has played 200 tests and gained almost all. Several centuries in both Test matches and one day. Here's the information about your past cricketer, Sachin Tendulkar. And after taking all the information, you just try to write a small paragraph. Okay, children, now look at that. So, full name, Sachin Tendulkar, and his nickname of Sachin the Cricket Master. You are born on 24th April 1973. Bombay, and height, it is 5 feet 5 inches, and roll all rounder, and the batting style is right handed. Okay? So I think you all know this, and if you don't know, you can watch any of the paper statements also, and after that, you can do this at home. So now you can see the matches. He has played 200 test matches, and he has scored 15,931 runs in test matches, and his top score was 248, and he secured 51 centuries and took 46 wickets in the test match. And there are the figures for one day match also. He has played 463 one day matches. This is the percentage that we can know that he has played test match. And even he has scored 18,026 runs, and his top score was 200 at the double century. And he has hit that century, he was 49 at the 50 also, sorry. And that we just took it to the opening. And he won the result 154. And now, this is the information about Sachin Tendulkar. And try to get more information and write a paragraph on this. Yes. Now, let us look at the sentences on the screen. Usha was a tiny village girl. She was an extremely bright student. And if you look at the two words, the red colored words, they are as a gift because they describe Usha. Right? And the adjectives are placed before nouns to modify the quality, quantity, time, and number of a person or thing. This is what we call as adjectives. And now, here is some small task for you regarding the adjectives. And look at the cat, and look at the cat, And this is the same goes like this. My neighbor's car is a cash car. So first one, we can go with A to Z as it is. This will be useful in your life to describe the person, place, or thing. Now, the first one, my neighbor's cat is an awful cat. My neighbor's cat is an happy cat. We can say it's an angry cat. We can say it's a brown cat. We can say it's a blind cat. It's a blind cat, right? It's a busy cat. It's a beautiful cat. It's a bad cat. It's a gay cat. It's a big cat. It's a brilliant cat. A nice cat. It's a cute cat. And then we can say it's a cunning cat. And we can say it's a cool cat. And it's a clever cat. And it's a dirty cat. It's a little dog like it. And then it's a different cat. So all these words tell about the quality of the cat. Right? So now, these are the adjectives we are talking about. Let us take some more examples and do this exercise. So, Usha heard the magical words. Can you identify the adjective there? So, what kind of words do you see here? Magical words, right? And next, see more from a distant village. So, village. Distant is very far. The next, the distant is the adjective. And we saw the distant child to her parents. So what kind of child she was? She was a distant child with wonderful abilities. And she was an individual child. What are the adjectives? It is individual. Right? So, sometimes we use more than one adjective to describe a person, place, or thing, or an object. They may give us information about things like quality, color, age, make, or shape of a person, place, or thing, or an object. Right. Now, if you look at the quality, it was a pleasant day. Okay, it talks about the quality of the day. It was a small day, the size, age. Temperature, a hot day, shape, a square table, and then we talk about the color, it's a black cat, right? So, now, look at the word out of the adjectives. Up to now, we have learned about the adjectives, what are the qualities, and what are different kinds of adjectives, but these adjectives follow certain rules. Maybe we cannot say that what are the rules, but I'll give you some clues here. First of all, look at the sentence. It is Rani's beautiful, old, brown, Indian, handle, wooden table. But this is a bigger sentence, and we will see the small sentence more badly. When we use two or more adjectives to describe the noun, we have to take care of the word order. The position of the adjective depends on how closely they are related to the noun. Right, children? So, I told you that though hard and fast is cannot be given, there are some guidelines that will be helpful. First one, you have to think about the quantity. Then, size or age. Then, color, origin. From where it is made in the material. If you look at the sentence, they bought a beautiful, large, blue, Kashmiri silk sock. Okay? If you find all these things were beautiful, it first talks about their quality, how it is beautiful. And the next one is large, it talks about size. And the next order is blue, the color. And origin from where it is? It is Kashmiri. And how it is made, the material? It is thick. So this is the order we have to follow. So children, look at this task for you. This is the last task. Rewrite the sentences with the first order of adjectives. So Usha was born at farm. Mother's old house. Things that we cannot read it because it's not in a proper order. And the second one is Usha is dad, little husband. There are flowers, some beautiful rose, like in our garden. It is new, my textbook is. So now, first, just think how you can replace this sentence. So, this is what Usha was born at her mother's own farmhouse. And Usha is a child living garden. There are some beautiful white rose flowers in our garden. My new English textbook. Right, children? This is what we have learned about how P.T. Usha has created a sensation in the world of sports. And we have learned the adjectives and the order of adjectives. And in the writing area, we have learned how to write an application and how to talk about your favorite cricketer, or you can write about any sports league. Right, children? Thank you. Let us meet in the next class. Until then, bye. Happy learning, children. Wish you all the best. And do the work.